Uganda has the highest per capita banana consumption in the world. On average, every Ugandan consumes around 200 kilograms of bananas each year. But unpredictable climate-induced changes in weather patterns are hitting Uganda's agriculture sector hard. Smallholder banana farmers are especially at risk, with unpredictable weather causing 60% of climate-related losses. They also often lack access to financial services that could help them to cope with the impact of climate change on their livelihoods.
I've got a challenge in climate change whereby the rain delays to flow and the crops are dry, and when it comes to rain, it comes heavily with wind and hailstorm. Last year in October, I made a loss of 300 trees. I had no food, had no fees for my children, and this year it has happened already.
There is no big industrial establishment that would undertake the kind of production that you see now under smallholder without insurance. A bigger farmer would be insured. The smallholder farmers are not insured. So they really are on the mercy of God.
To meet this challenge, the Uganda Banana Industrial Research and Development Center is teaming up with Acre Africa and the Agro Insurance Consortium to offer a solution for climate-vulnerable rural communities, picture-based insurance. This new insurance is delivered through smartphones, helping banana farmers recover faster financially from extreme weather events.
The picture-based technology allows the farmer to be part and parcel of the insurance process from the beginning of the season to the end. We use a technology of photos where we geo-map a farm to monitor the risks that would affect the farmer throughout the season.
With that information, the program leverages artificial intelligence and machine learning to offer advice, helping farmers improve productivity while reducing the cost of insurance.
They taught us on how they can refund our properties when we get the loss. So now I'm sure that if I get such a loss, the picture-based insurance is in place.
Picture-based insurance shows that tailored climate smart financing products can help vulnerable communities to adapt to the worst impacts of the climate crisis. Climate smart financing can also be used to address the causes of climate change. Through the Solar Electric Cooking Partnership, a platform that fosters public-private partnerships to advance solutions and increase access to climate finance, the Ugandan government, UNEP, and private sector partners are making solar-powered electric cookers more affordable for low-income households, including refugee-hosting communities.
The good advantage with renewable energy solutions is whilst the upfront cost is high, the operational cost is quite low. Within 1 year's time, you should have recovered on that upfront cost.
Currently, over 90% of Ugandan households use wood or charcoal for cooking banana and other staple foods. Low interest loans and pay-as-you-go purchases, along with incentives and credits for suppliers, are helping the transition to more fuel-efficient energy use and reducing the burden on Uganda's natural resources. The success of these financial products mean that they are now being scaled up and rolled out across the country. There are plans for up to 50,000 banana farmers to participate in the picture-based insurance scheme, providing a lifeline to those at the forefront of climate change.
Innovative tools for climate smart financing do exist in the market. With the right public policies and regulatory frameworks in place, governments can get these critical financing solutions into the hands of the people who need it most.
As Uganda reviews its nationally determined contributions to the Paris Agreement, these climate smart financing initiatives show how climate finance can be taken to the last mile and reach the most vulnerable communities.
Everybody has a role to play. The private sector, the civil society, and the other key stakeholders.
Every fraction of a degree matters.